well in that space of you're sick, we just know this is what we're up against, and so we treat it as such.
It's a mindset Leah Kirschival and her family have had for nearly 2 years, ever since her now six-year-old daughter Louisa was diagnosed with leukemia.
We like to look at this as temporary, and so though it's inconvenient, and it has been inconvenient for the past 2 years because you miss a lot of life, it's so much better in the long run, and there's not a price tag that I could put on health.
During that time, Louisa has been at her home near Columbus receiving chemotherapy through Riley Children's Hospital. The medicine fights her disease while also fighting her body.
There have been many times in the past few months where her counts have bottomed out. And by counts, I mean that's red blood cell, white blood cell, platelets, all of that. And so she may seem healthy on the outside, but it's your body just kind of shuts down and has nothing to fight off.
With a weak immune system, her family has always had to be extra careful. Even more so now, with a new coronavirus spreading across the country.
We currently do not have much data specific to COVID-19 and immunocompromised children, but based on information about other patients with significant chronic illnesses, we're all concerned about their well-being.
Riley Dr. Emily Mueller says it's extremely important to keep the virus away from kids like Louisa, but that also means keeping it away from parents, siblings, grandparents, and anyone providing them care.
Again, I have to really stress that we need to take ourselves off the table and our own personal risk and really begin to think of others around us.
Outside of doctor's visits, Louisa stays at home. Her family has had to sacrifice a lot to keep her safe. But now with a global pandemic, the country has to do the same.
And I'm not saying to go hide yourself, and I'm not saying to panic, and I'm not saying to freak out, but I'm just saying to be considerate and to begin to think of the other person.